Okay, so I showed you how to make the envelope, and this will be the chest that it goes into. And one of the things I want to show you with the chest is kind of how many possibilities there are. There's many different ways you can do this. So the envelope's the easiest one to make. But if you were to make a chest, you want four sides. And so right away you can kind of picture it like here, 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 and here. If you divide this into quarters, you can already get four sides, not counting the other two that make a total of six to get a three-dimensional piece. All right, fold this in half. Fold those halves into halves. Okay. So you can already see it. Already picture it, and you fold each of these folds at 90 degrees, you've already got the beginnings of kind of like a box or a chest. It's going to look more like a chest because it's going to be more, the length, it'll have a length, it won't be a cube. So in order to get a shape like that, I'm going to use a quarter of the page here and a quarter of the page here for the fifth and sixth side. And to do that, we need to know where the halfway point is. So just fold this in half here. Little pinch here. And a little pinch here. We don't want to fold the whole thing because it's not necessary. We're just using it to measure where to fold this next fold. Okay, there we go. So look at it now, and you already know that this is going to be the front, this is going to be the top, this will be the back, and this will be the bottom. So all we really have to worry about is from here to here, we've got to somehow make this into a solid plate. Same with this side. And there's so many ways you can do this. I've experimented over the years, and you almost can't go wrong. That's what I love about it. I can show you my favorite way of doing it first, but I'm going to show you also just what you can do. So for me, what I do is I make a fold here and I make a fold here. This is my most, this is the design I'm partial to, but there's a lot of other ones I've come up with. So do whatever feels good to you. All right, so to get that fold, fold it like this. And we're going to bring this over to this corner, one corner to the other, like that. Okay, and then same with this side. Okay, so there we go. Now we've got two on this side. And let's do it on this side as well. Okay. Sometimes when I do these videos, I notice I don't fold as well as I normally do. I think I've got stage fright or something. Okay, there we go. Mm-hmm. we go. So for me, what I do is, if you fold it like this, you fold it like this, you have it over here, right away, you are already sort of developing a side here, like this. Now, I am very well aware that this is sticking out, and we'll take care of that later. But yeah, right away you're sort of you can see what you can do. And before I do anything, take the four corners, and there's a little square towards the outlying corners, and just fold that diagonally, but just that one square, not the whole sheet, just the end, up to this point here. Okay, do it to all of them. Might seem like a lot of trouble just for one fold, but it's really hard to get much. You don't have any kind of surface to work on when you're folding something like this. I mean, I can put my hand under it, but it won't be quite as good. Ideally, I have something that comes up like an upside down pencil holder or something. Okay, so I've got that, and then you've got these. And basically, one's going to fold over like this, and then this one, which it doesn't really matter which direction, which one comes first, whether it's this one or the first one I showed you, but you want it to work the same way on both sides. I'm probably going to have this be the front, so this will actually be inserted into this triangle. This will be the pocket here, and this will be the flap. Okay, and I'm going to get that on this side too. Got to get it ready. You want to kind of do this at the same time because it'll hold better that way. Okay. And this will come down like that. So let's insert it. If we can. Okay, so this will go into here. At least that's the idea. Okay, there we go. That's starting to go. There we go. All right. Love it when it finally gets nice and snug. So there you go. You've got
one right now. And it's got this little opening here. But the sides are very secure. And the envelope that I just made earlier will go inside here. And it will improve the look of it quite a bit. This is my favorite way to have, at least, to combine these. But there's also lots of other ways.
The way I'm going to do it for this one is I like it to be a little more decorative. So I want to show a little more white. So I'm going to fold this part back. And granted, you lose a little bit of the stability. I mean, it locks much better the way I had it before. But I like a little white. What can I say? I like it to look like it has a little bit of a handle, because it is going to be a chest. So by folding this back, you make it, it's all for decorative purposes, and that's it. It actually doesn't really help it other than that. But it's still feasible to get this in here and get it to still hold itself. Let me do this side. That. Okay. And by the way, I highly encourage, if you're trying to kind of do things on your own, you'd like to make your own designs, you know, just don't pay attention to any of this and see if you can just do it on your own without, like, how would you make a fifth and sixth side for a little box? So there you go. Now we got the little handles here. Like that. And if you're curious, I'll show you some other possibilities if you don't like the way this looks. For example, open the whole thing up, get rid of the white handles that I just made. And if we go back to this, if you remember at the beginning, I said make folds here and make fold here. Well, let's try making a fold the other way, like this and like this. Okay, let's do that real quick. Because the truth is, I arrive at these places quite stupidly. And I don't really know what I'm doing. And I think it makes people a little more confident, and I think it's fun to sort of discover things by chance and kind of figure out what it is later on. I love to just make something and then go, I think it looks like a flower or a star or whatever. It's not even important what it is. It's just more like, do you like what you made? At least for me. But I do know a lot of people who are always like saying to me, what is that? And I'll say, I don't know, but I like it. Okay, so I made some other extra folds here. I'll give you an idea. If you just fold it like this, you can see all kinds of things that can happen here. Like, and it doesn't have to necessarily be folded. Let's see. Let's try this, for example. So I go like this. I go like this. Okay, here we go. Got something here. I do tend to keep this part for this. But look, this is very plain and simple. This just crosses under this, like this, and then this can go inside this. So if you wanted a more, a less flashy side, like a more just simple, just completely flat, completely red, this this is an option. It's not completely flat, but I mean it's pretty flat. And this is probably the most, this is probably more secure and solid than what I was doing. So if you want it to really be symmetrical and hold itself together really well, that is one way you could do it, is like this. I just wanted to show that just to give you an example of what how many different variations there are to a side. I mean, I have it like, I had it like this earlier, and then I also added the white handle. There's so many different ways you can do it, so have fun with it.
Now, if you want to combine this with the little chest I made earlier, you take your little chest, and this happened by accident. I realized when I made these, they were kind of the right proportions to do this. I didn't plan on it, so sometimes these things happen by dumb luck. But if you put this inside here, like this, it really looks quite nice.